Mortal Kombat Legends Battle of the Realms. This is on 4K from Warner Brothers, the second in the animated Mortal Kombat films, which I do enjoy. I enjoyed The Curse of Scorpion, and this one, which is more of a Liu Kang story, obviously, is pretty solid as well. If you're into the video games, it kind of deals with more along the lines of the plot of Part 2 to 3 to Ultimate, blah, 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 blah. Because basically, Shao Kahn convinces Raiden to have one final Mortal Kombat tournament right after Earth just won the last one, and winner takes all, pretty much. And meanwhile, while this is going on, you've got people trying to use Scorpion to unlock this powerful being that can just basically wipe out everybody, which just seems to be new to me. I don't remember that from the video games. I could be wrong. I don't remember that part, though. You also have the side plot with the new Sub-Zero after the events of the last one. If you haven't seen it, we'll spoil that. He's here. And also, his clan is here. Smoke and Cyrax and all those guys. And it actually deals with the plot of those guys being turned into robots. So it crams a lot in here. It manages to make characters like Striker even interesting. There's actually a few deaths in here that might surprise you a little bit. There's some gruesome, bloody stuff. It's all animated, but I mean, like I said, it gets pretty graphic in the violence department. And that's what you want. And it also does a good job of actually making sense out of the format of this Mortal Kombat tournament as they do battle and all that stuff. So if you're familiar with the, like I said, the video games, you're kind of going to know where things are going here. But Raiden, Jax, Sub-Zero, Johnny Cage is in this. Liu Kang, Shao Kahn, Katana, all those people that you recognize right here. Even some lesser ones that never really seem to you know, become anything. Like I said, Striker series is actually kind of interesting while he's around in it. So I enjoyed it. And I think if you like the last one, it's a solid follow-up to that. Gets a little weird near the end, maybe. If it had a weak point, it might be the end of it, because this whole subplot with this being and, you know, Scorpion and stuff like that, it's a little different than what I'm used to. But it's okay. And it gives kind of even another baddie for Liu Kang and the gang to try to defeat, which, of course, is Mortal Kombat. So you never really know how things are going to end up. But it's the 4K. It looks good. I mean, it should look good. It's animated, but I don't really... Maybe it's my eyes, I don't know. But I don't really notice too big of a difference between the Blu-ray and 4K when it comes to this animated stuff like this. But it is solid. I think I like the Scorpion one a tad bit better, but still, I like this one solid enough to give it a 3 out of 5. Special features, the god and the dragon battling for Earthrealm, an audio commentary, and a gag reel. So this is available now from Warner Brothers. Another solid follow-up to The Curse of Scorpion. Or Scorpion's Curse, or whatever it was, Scorpion's Revenge. Probably, maybe even being done a little bit better than the actual live-action Mortal Kombat at this point. But if you're into Mortal Kombat, I definitely suggest you give this one a watch.